Good morning, everybody. Today, I'm gonna be having some coffee and playing with clay. Okay, so I'm trying something different on my channel to see what you guys think, kind of a different approach. Maybe just sit and relax, do some different things with clay, and also trying something different with a sculpture. I never really do like a full armature and then cover it with clay. So just want to try something new and also something new on YouTube and see what you guys think. So please let me know if you like it. And here we go. I went with a, I'm doing the Primo Accent. It's like a pearl kind of clay. And it's like really easy to condition. It's nice and soft. So I figured it would be easier to use for this because it's quicker in case I need to condition on the fly. Okay, so I have my chat up. Hello, everybody. So this guy was kind of cool. He's like, well, I hope he'll turn out cool. Some kind of prowling something. So this is outside of my comfort zone, covering with clay like this. So I'm really excited to try it, something new. I hope you guys like it as well. Maybe we do some more of these or like little half hour sessions, just sit and relax and play with clay. Doing like a granite gray color to start. Oh, this guy's gonna take a lot of clay. Thanks, guys, for the kind words, Juniper Fox and Stickbot. It's a good time to sit and ask questions, too, if you guys have any while I'm doing this. I'm just gonna cover the armature up with clay and then see what happens from there. Because if you watch my other videos, you'll know that normally I have like this little armature and it makes my clay really smooth when I'm working with it because I get to roll it, you know, like I always do. This is different because I have to smooth it with my tools. Thanks, Gabby. I like making them a lot because I taught myself how to do this, and I figured anybody else that would want to do it would hopefully like to watch the videos just to avoid the learning curve that I had to do. I've messed up so much in these. But that's how you learn, right? You learn by doing. And I learn more from my mistakes than ever. Okay, so Juniper is asking how long have I been doing clay? And you've been at it for a year, but you're taking on a break. Oh, you know what? I take breaks too. As you can see, I haven't posted anything for a month. I had like a little vacation and then just the tediousness of editing videos made me not want to make videos for a while. So I was doing some clay stuff, but I wasn't recording it. So I've been doing this since 2015. So I guess 3 years now. work from home, so my husband wanted me to get a hobby, so he got me clay for Christmas. And that was that. I was hooked. Oh, what's my favorite creation? That's probably one that I still have. Hang on. I can't tell it. I love it so much. I really like making the Oriental dragons the best, if I'm being honest with myself. Just something about them. The hair and the horns and... I don't know. They're just really fun. Can you guys see this okay? Like what I'm doing? So far I've added clay to the back. And I'm kind of working on the tummy. And I'm going through a lot of clay. This is a lot bigger than my normal creations, by the way. Like a lot bigger. Normally, my dragons are this big. So yeah, this will be exciting and epic. I do sell my creations, and hello Lizzie. I usually put in all my descriptions like a link to my Etsy site. So I have an Etsy page where I put up everything I make, and you can go there. I'll maybe look up Kiwi Koi Originals on Etsy and see if you can find it, but I'll be putting a link in the description once I'm done with this. Let's see, where should this go? Sorry for my shaky hands. I'm nervous. So at the moment, I am just kind of trying to cover up all the foil. And what I did was I took some wire, like floral wire or wire you can get at like Home Depot or something, and I made this basic shape with it by twisting it around, and then I covered it up in foil, then I wrapped that foil in what's it called, it's this stuff like insulation tape. Just helps hold all the foil together, and yeah. Oh, and my coffee today is vanilla sugar cookie. Looking like something. And if you guys like the videos, like if you like this, what I'm doing right now, for like, you know, maybe I'll do a couple half hour deals, then maybe we can do longer ones. See if you guys like it first. And I found out with the one live stream that I did a while ago, that your guys' chat questions that you're asking right now don't pop up in the, you know, the regular YouTube thing. After the fact, after I'm done streaming. So, that's why, like, if somebody were to watch it and I just answer a random question, they won't know what I'm talking about. So that's why I'm going to repeat your question if you ask. This tool is awesome, by the way. I can't, like, say enough good things about it. It is a crochet needle from Joann's, and, like, if you can see this, let's see if I can get it just right, it just blends everything so easily. So Gabby is asking if I can make toothless. I actually get that question a lot. I can try. It would probably be in my style because I don't want there to be any copyright issues. I'm not exactly sure what is safe and what is not safe to make, or if there's no issue at all since it's a clay thing. But yeah, I can give it a try. I think he's really cute, so that'd be fun. Okay, so Leanne is asking if this is going to be a dragon. I want it to be. I want it very much to be a dragon. Like a stalking sort of deal. My son wants it to be a panther, but no. No, it must be a dragon. I can make a panther some of the time. This would be so cool. Like horns coming out or something. Maybe like some big old spikes down the back or coming off the legs. Yeah, it's gotta be a dragon. It's gotta be. Dan says I should add big wings. That would be cool. I have to figure out how to do it. Maybe, okay, so I could either maybe have wings coming off the legs, like the Game of Thrones dragons, you know, the wyvern type of dragon, or I could have big wings, like folded back, like he's tucking them in, getting ready to jump or something. I don't know. So I kind of make up my stuff as I go. I don't know if you guys know that or not. I have no, like, other than the color. No thoughts of what my dragons are going to look like. They just kind of make themselves as they go. I'll set things here and there and kind of look at it and say, do I like that? No, I don't like it. And then I'll move it. So we'll see as it goes what it turns out. Let's see, we'll cover up the arm next. Ooh, yes. Stickbot says I should do a two-headed dragon. I've actually been wanting to do a two-headed dragon really bad. All right, arm. Get on there. Air, get out of there. that'd be cool. Especially if I end up doing okay with this whole armature thing. The only reason I haven't done a two-headed dragon is because I don't know how to make it, like, nice and sturdy for the head. But maybe this can change all that. There's some air in here, I just know it. Yep. That's like the worst, is when you get air against your armature and your clay when you're trying to close it up. That's no fun, because then you have to start stabbing and ripping and pulling apart and ugh. So yeah, I was kind of hoping, like, if this does turn out to be something that you guys like, you know, could make it at a certain time every week, maybe more than once a week, and everybody just grabs their coffee and relaxes, and we make something fun, you know? There's air in it still. Maybe I need to cut some off. Okay. Gabby is asking if I sell them. Yes, I do sell them. I have an Etsy page, and I'll put the link in the description when I'm done with this, or you can try and find me on Etsy at Kiwi Koi Originals. But yes, I do sell my dragons. Right now I'm blending my seams for all the different pieces I've been adding, just trying to cover up the foil. It seems like this is coming together nicely. It's holding its shape at least. That's a bonus. So, Juniper is saying, got a box at Christmas where you can put items, like tools and nails and stuff, putting clay in it. That's awesome. Yep. I went to Michael's, and I get their little, like, scrapbooking trays. I'll show you. Okay. Are you ready for the epicness? This is awesome. where I keep my clay. Each one has a different color and it's all primo. I love it. I love it so much. Perfect. Sure, it's big, but I have a lot of clay, so I need big. Yes, Juniper. It is big and it is awesome. You guys are always welcome to look me up on or message me on Facebook. I'm on Facebook as well. Or Instagram. And show me if you do clay. Show me your stuff. Show me what you keep your things in, you know? Love seeing that. Or show me your creations. Yeah, so Leanne is doing clay as well and wants to show me your stuff. Please find me on Facebook. Give me a message or Instagram. I'm on both of them and I would love to see it. And if you guys ever have questions about anything, feel free to ask. On also Facebook and Instagram. Because I just want to help. I had nothing and no outlet when I was doing this, starting out. I would have loved to have someone to bounce questions off of. And when I first started this, my little dragons that I do on all my other videos, they used to take me like, oh God, 4, 5, and 6 hours to do, and then eventually, as I learned different techniques of, you know, cutting time, different ways of assembling it to make it faster, I cut it down to like an hour and a half to 2 hours. So that's what my hope is with my YouTube channel, is just to help people do it faster, fix any problems they might have. I guess I'll cover the head now. Hello, Night Dragon, and thank you so much. So I'm obviously going to build up the head. I made it small on purpose to start. Because the way I do my eyes now, with the beads that I use, I love using the beads. I'm going to need some empty space to poke with my little eye tool that I use. Get out here. So what I'm going to do is just build up clay over the top so I can poke holes and not run into a wall of foil. Yeah, Leanne is saying that a lot of people, a lot of artists are secretive. They are. And I've come up upon a ton that just like, figure it out, do it yourself. I was like, I just have a simple question. I'm struggling and I would like a little help. I'm not trying to copy your design. I just want a little help with some technique. So I was trying to figure it all out myself and I don't care. I'll show you my technique. I don't care. I mean, your stuff's gonna be your stuff. My stuff's my stuff. Cool. Look how he's turning out. Got an air bubble. I can see it. Can you guys see it? I'm gonna stab it. Bye, Gabby. Thanks for watching. I'm trying to keep up with chat and still get progress on this going. What am I missing? Oh, Stickbot wants me to make a pushing cat. Huh, that'd be cute. That's the little gray cat, right? Oh yeah, Juniper, a pushing dragon. That'd be neat. I like doing that. I like making dragons of things. Like I did a Wonder Woman dragon once. That was fun. I wanted to kind of make all the Justice League. I thought that would be neat. And then there's no copyright issues because it's a dragon. Okay. Smoothing out my lines in the belly. I'm using a ball tool to kind of just get where my fingers can't. Up any foil that starts poking through because I kind of have like a thin layer. Need some coffee. Dragon says I deserve more subscribers. Well, thank you. Thank you very much. I'm actually almost at 1,000 and I've been doing this now. I don't know when I started. I have to look. I want to say maybe we're almost getting close to a year, perhaps. I don't think quite a year though. But boy, oh boy, is it a struggle on YouTube, if you even think about wanting to get monetized, holy cow. And now they made it even harder. It kind of bummed me out a little bit because I was making headway, but oh well, it is what it is. That's why I'm trying something new. Instead of just my videos of time-lapsing, let's see how this does. Maybe this will get fairly entertaining. Okay, so Juniper is asking if I've ever shattered one of my creations. I have dropped. something. I'm all excited, and I'm showing my husband. I'm like, look! And then it falls for some strange reason, because of course it's going to fall. Why wouldn't it? And like something will pop off, like a horn or whatever. I haven't shattered. It just had something pop off. And what's really cool about this clay, I don't know if you guys know this or not, you can rebake it as many times as you want. 1,000 times if you wish. And it'll be just fine. So what you do if something like pops off, you can either get another little piece of clay, put it on it, and try and sculpt it back together, you know? Or you can get Big and Bond or Translucent Liquid Sculpty, TLS. That stuff, it works like glue. It's like, it just makes everything stick back together. Although if you get it outside of where you're trying to glue a piece back together, it will look like glue on your little figure. So just, you know, clean it up when you're working with it. On this tail. But yes, I have messed up so many things. Well, not really messed up, but like things happen in the oven. It's like, how in the world did that happen? You were standing and now you're on your face. Or you had an arm and now you don't have an arm. So many things. But I can fix everything. Like anything can be fixed. You fix it and you throw it back in the oven. You wouldn't believe it. I've had to cut off tails before and re-put them back on, and my goodness. You'd be amazed. Everything can be fixed. Just don't, of course, well, you're gonna get frustrated. But try not to get frustrated. Just like, huh, well, maybe it's a learning experience. Maybe next time I'll do this so this won't happen, you know? When you put in your armatures, make sure you twist them nice and tight. That way it'll hold its shape so it doesn't slouch when you're cooking it in the oven. You know, because if you have a nice big head, nice heavy head on your guy, it's going to want to pull it down, you know. Or even if you put in armatures in your wings, you know, those always end up looking floppy if you don't add a nice armature. And yeah. Leanne is asking, what's the difference between the two, Bake and Bond and Translucent Liquid Sculpey? Okay, so here's the deal. Translucent Liquid Sculpey, think of it like glue. I mean, it is liquid sculpey. It is like what I'm working with, except liquid form. So it's really good to help bond things together. Now here's the deal with Bake and Bond. It is for already cooked clay, and you want to add not cooked clay to it. It bonds it. But it can be used also as just glue. It works both ways. So that's the difference. One is for already cooked clay when you want to add something to it to help it stick better. And one is just like a glue. All right, so Juniper says, sorry, somebody rang my doorbell, so now my dogs are barking. I can't go get it. Hopefully my son goes and gets it and stops then. Okay, so you put it in the oven without any kind of support, and I'm assuming it fell over. I don't put any support on my things. I use a 3x5 card, and then, you know, I'll put the creation on it. And then it's just, you want to make sure your armature is strong enough and your clay is thick enough on the parts that are where it's sitting up compared to where, like, the tail comes out, so that it doesn't go in the oven, you know? It's a trial and error thing. I still don't have it perfect. Sometimes I'll have mine in there and I'll come back and they're like, to the side. It's like, man, okay, so I needed to maybe put a little more support on this side, or maybe thickened up the clay or tightened up my joints. It's all a learning process. I still don't have it down perfect. I am still working it out myself. Leanne loves my logo. Thank you. I love it as well. And my little koi fish. Coffee. I like koi fish. I like koi fish a lot. I just finished a koi pond in my backyard. And I am staring at it right now. Like, how cool is that? I get to look at a beautiful koi pond while I'm sculpting. Ugh. Happiness. So I'm thinking, as I'm working on this, that this video is just going to be me covering them up in gray clay. And then I'll have to do another video or something with the next step. I'm not sure how long I've been doing this yet. How long have I been doing this, guys? How long are we at in this video? T Green says, dog likes to steal the clay. Figures need them. Oh my gosh. Oh, that would be horrible. I couldn't imagine spending like 3 hours on something, and they do smell good. Like, okay, I have to admit, when they come out of the oven, I smell them. There, now you know. It smells like flour or like a maybe Play-Doh. I don't know. They smell good. I like it. So you guys got to do that next time your stuff comes out of the oven. Give it a little sniff. It's fun. It's like smelling a pack of cards for those who play card games. New card smell. Oh, it's great. It makes one happy. And if what you're doing isn't making you happy, then you shouldn't be doing it. Okay, I have to push this down because it's sticking out. And now I have to cover it up. This is a lot of clay. Woo! This guy is a beast. He's huge. Leanne is asking how I came up with a name. Like, for my business? Like Kiwi Koi Originals? Okay. Did you take something you like? Like, my mom, my name's Carrie. Hi, I'm Carrie. And my mom called me Kiwi when I was young. And I really like koi fish. My husband was like, you should call it Kiwi Koi. I'm like, oh my gosh, that's awesome. I shall do that. And that is how my name came to be for my business. And I try to never, ever, ever make the same thing twice. So I added originals on to the end of the name. Kiwi Koi Originals. Leanne says it's nice to know my backstory. Thanks. actually the first time I've ever told it. So what do you guys think so far? And, like, should I keep going or should I? Is the stream getting long? I don't know. I'm not familiar with these things. I know when people do stuff on Twitch, they stream for a long time. But this is not Twitch, so I don't know. Leanne would like me to keep going. All right. I'll keep going. Can't wait to give them little paws. I love little paws. Covering up the feet. Leanne, I am never bored sculpting. I can sculpt for hours. It's fun because I don't even know what it's gonna look like. It's exciting to see it like come to shape. It's like, oh, this is really cool. And oh, look how that's turning out. And then you'll get like inspiration while you're working. And it's just, I never get bored. I love doing it. I just hope that you guys aren't bored. Alright, so Tommy keeps poking out. Stop poking out, Tommy. Gabby's asking if I've made a rainbow dragon before. I have not. I've made a rainbow haired pony, but not a dragon. Straighten out the tummy right now. Let's get these feet covered up. Oh, yes. Leanne, sometimes I have to go to the chiropractor after I'm done. Because normally I stand and I don't sit. So my back takes a toll. And I stand because if I'm doing the other recording, I have this thing, this little guy, propped up in front of me with my phone on it, recording for you guys. So I have to like be at a weird angle doing my sculpting. So if I'm standing, it's just easier to record. But I knock it over all the time. bit of a hassle. Still blending the seams here, the arms. It's almost all covered up. That's exciting. There's a lot of seams because there's a lot of clay. Juniper is asking what my biggest pet peeve is when it comes to clay. Hers is when you bake it and you realize there's a strand of orange cat fur in it. Haha! Yeah, my dogs, oh my gosh. They love coming around and trying to get their hair everywhere. You know, I would have to say my biggest pet peeve is hair and clay. Yep. Currently, there's like a lint mafia at my house. And whenever I work with any kind of light colored clay, that is the time to attack. Oh my goodness, I hate it. I like working with dark colored clay because you can't see any lint in it. Unless it's like white lint, but. Yeah. Oh. Because I was like, I just want to sculpt. I don't want to spend forever picking stuff out, you know? And then you have to spend all that time afterwards with your alcohol and your Q-tips trying to get all the little pieces of lint off. It's just not fun. Bit of foil sticking out right there, get covered up. Yeah. So yeah, okay, so for those who are doing this, if you ever have to do this, sometimes you'll have an errant piece of foil sticking out where you don't want it. Then you find something and you just shove it right back in there. Push it down with something. And then cover it up again. Okay. All right. So let's finish covering this tail. Gabby's asking, what made me love dragons? When I was a kid, there was a cartoon called Flight of Dragons. Really old. Really old. And that is what made me love dragons. Because there are so many different kinds of dragons in that little cartoon. It was like a D&D type-ish of cartoon. And, yeah. That's made me, so I love everything fantasy, but dragons are the best. They're just so flippin' cool. And the horns and the spikes and their wings. I love them so much. And I'm still shocked that I make them. I make dragons. How cool is that? It's so fun. I have to condition more. Thankfully, it's not that hard. Let's Leanne always gets black stuff or black dots in your white clay. Yeah. Just, you know, you try to wash your hands before. I always take a shower before I do my clay. That way I'm just fresh and clean and nothing on my hands. I always have this with me so that if I am changing colors, I rub my hands really, really hard to get them out of my fingerprints. Sometimes I'll like have a piece of translucent clay or something, and I'll rub my hands around in that and condition that for a bit so it can pull the different color clay out of my fingerprints. Because that'll get in your other colors as well. Sometimes I'll just go wash my hands again, scrub them really good, get the colors off. Alright, so we gotta at least get this tail covered up. Yeah, Leanne, no problem. Yeah, the only thing I could say for getting black dots is rubbing alcohol, Q-tip, put it in, and you rub little circular motions to just get those colors off, or take your finger if you're still working on it and give it a light little scratch and then smooth it back over. That's what I have to do. Once I find the cure for getting rid of stupid little black specks, I'll let you know. But so far, we have to deal with them. Okay, let's get this tail wrapped up, shall we? Do it in little tiny pieces that way we don't have this air bubble problem we had earlier with the arm. Oh, Gabby's asking if I've ever tried making a sea dragon. yes. I actually recently just made one, but I didn't record it because I was just it was on a whim, and I just wanted to create and not worry about all the setup and the editing and all that. I'm gonna make another one though, and I'll get it recorded for you guys, or maybe we'll do it with the coffee and clay. It was really neat. He was like, he was a light blue, and then it transitioned into dark blue, and then that transitioned into a dark purple. And he had like little, like flowy, connected spikes, strip mohawk deal down his back. He was neat. Oh, and he had cute little black eyes, and he was like kind of almost furry looking. It was the texture that I gave him made him look kind of furry. And he had a little button nose. It's one thing I usually don't give my dragons is noses, but a few times lately I've been attempting it and I like how it's been turning out, so I might do it some more. Tail's almost covered. So the tail is now covered, huzzah, and now I just have to smooth it out and find any bubbles in case there are any. I hope there's not. Don't like them. Don't like them at all. What? Oh, okay. So Juniper's asking, what's my proudest creation? I would have to say I made a dragon sitting on top of a pile of gold. And it took me around 15 hours to make. So I made every single little piece of gold and stacked it on there. Made a little treasure for it to be sitting on, and its tail was like swimming through the gold and popping out the other side. He was sitting on it. I'd have to say that one. That was my most proudest and epicest creation. I have pictures of all my things, by the way, on Instagram and on Facebook. So if you guys want to find me on there, you can see everything I've ever made. It's there. Oh, and for those that don't know, this little crochet needle, this used to be my smoothing tool. Like, this was my old favorite tool. It smooths just as well. But for some reason, the metal slides like a lot easier on the clay. And it blends it a lot faster for some reason. I don't know why, but it does. And so I like it. Gabby's asking, have I made a skeleton dragon before? I have not. I've made a horse before that kind of had some bones sticking out of it. But I haven't made a skeleton dragon. I gotta figure out how to, I want to very much. But I gotta figure out how to make it look like, you know, the skeleton is there and whatever's holding the skeleton. I don't know if it would have to be something like this where I cover up all the bones, you know? Since I'm just learning this, maybe that will be the answer to the skeleton dragon. So we shall see. There's an air bubble. And it's annoying. You can tell if there's an air bubble because when you're grabbing and pushing and tightening up your clay and fixing seams, it'll move. It's like, why are you moving? You shouldn't be moving. You should be tight against the foil. So, air bubble So you have to cut a little hole to the metal part and then try to squeeze the air out and get it tight. For those that don't know, if you keep your air bubbles in your clay and you cook it, it's gonna go boop and make like a little, like it blew a bubble in your clay. That's another pet peeve, air bubbles. There we go, we found one. Oh yeah. Freaking air bubbles. God. God. Just go away. We'll call this the air bubble hour. Just gonna get rid of some clay. Let's see if that helps. And it did. See, what happens is, say this is the armature and I wrap my clay around it, but it connects like this. See? And the air would be in there. So I have to pop it and get it tight, or else the air will still be in there. And now you know. And no one needs half the battle. Gabby's asking, what about a butterfly dragon with beautiful butterfly wings? I have not. Again, I think that would come down to making the armature for the wings. Because if you notice also with my dragons, I don't make any wings that like stick up. Because that would require a big old armature. And I'm just kind of learning how to do this. So, in the future, we shall possibly see beautiful butterfly wing dragons. I'd like to make them. It'd be fun. Come on. Get out of there, foil. I don't want to see you. Thank you. Did we do it? Did we get it covered? Yes. So now you know, well, with this kind of sculpting, what an hour, it's been an hour, right? An hour's worth of sculpting looks like. For those wondering how long this stuff actually takes to do when it's not being time-lapsed. A lot of smoothing, a lot of blending, a lot of adding, a lot of taking away, a lot of popping bubbles. Look at that. Juniper's asking if I read Fire Within or Wings of Fire, both dragon books. I haven't, but I've seen them in the store, and I was really interested. So, you're saying it's good, yeah? I should read it? I'm already seeing something. Like, because you know how we don't know how this guy's going to turn out. Something with this tail. See how thick it is in the back? Maybe like a something. It almost looks like a scorpion tail, doesn't it? Super happy that the clay is on. Wings of Fire book series has 10 books. Wow. Holy cow. That's a lot of books. A lot of good reading though, huh? This is too thick. I need to cut some off. Now here's a question. Do you guys want me to save this for my next, like leave it right where it is and save it for another coffee and clay? so we can continue with it. Gabby's asking, have I ever made a unicorn dragon? I have not. I've made a unicorn pony. And I made a Kirin, which is kind of like a unicorn dragony horse thing. I have not made a unicorn dragon. That sounds very fun to make. What I could do between videos, if we do decide to save this for another video, I can get everything all smoothed out and ready to go for the next whatever it is I plan on doing with this guy. Show you guys what we have so far. Let me get a couple more things smoothed out and we'll check on the progress. And Gabby, never worry about asking questions. That is what I'm here for. All right. What do you guys think? I'll probably be looking up some maybe tiger prowling pictures or something just to get a better idea of how the bone structure will be for this guy. Just to make it somewhat anatomically correct. Juniper, thanks for watching. See you later. Okay, Leanna's asking when the next video, if I stop now. Well, I mean, if this one turned out pretty good, I mean, shoot. Maybe tomorrow, if that works for you guys. Bot is asking, what's the name of the dragon? Okay, I don't know yet. The name usually comes to me once it's done. You know, depending on how it ends up looking. Like, shoot, I called one Bruiser because of the state of my fingers after I was done making it. So, we shall see. Don't know yet. Right. Okay. So I think I will stop it here. so that we'll have something to work with tomorrow. I'll get them all smoothed out and ready to go with whatever we do tomorrow. Hopefully tomorrow. Thank you guys so, so much for watching. Look forward to next time. Thanks for enjoying clay and coffee. Or coffee and clay, whatever. And have a great day.